Good morning, students. Today we are going to learn about our first chapter, which is about the force. It has different components which we are going to learn. First is about translational motion. Then second is about rotational motion. Third thing about moment of force and its examples. Then comes the couple. Then the last one in this first few pages is equilibrium. So we'll deal one by one the translational motion, which you are learning in your 8th standard also, 9th standard also while doing it. So translational motion specifically deal with the motion with the direction. The word which in your book is important, the key words are important. A translational motion, motion with the direction. Rotational motion is when you are sitting in your classroom and you see overhead a fan rotating. It is a rotational motion. But in that we have to know that speed is constant, but it is accelerated motion since it changes the direction. Based on this, there are few examples which you can read from your book. So next time I'll mark and give you regarding these examples. We'll go to the most important aspect, that is the moment of force that we call about. Suppose you are near the door. The door have the hinges and they have the handle. So the handle is called when we apply the force, whereas the hinges are the rotational axis. So when we talk about moment of force, we have to consider into account the force into perpendicular distance. So the moment of force is equal to force into perpendicular distance. Now, if you cannot apply force anywhere, it should be from axis of rotation to the shortest distance. Now, shortest distance is the perpendicular distance. Therefore, moment of force is equal to force into perpendicular distance. Now, since force is measured in newtons, distance is in meters. So, the newton meter or dime centimeter. This year 2020 paper, this question had come in section A. So when we talk about that, the conversion will be 1 newton meter is equal to 10 raised to 7 dime centimeter. Now, so this, then the different examples of moment of force are there. Again, I'll mark and give you how to be going through it. Just it is the reading exercise which you can read. Now, important aspect in moment of force is we should know clockwise and anticlockwise. So the clockwise is taken as negative direction, anticlockwise is taken as positive direction. Now I am going to do a very small thing, just pay attention. I have a bottle over here, I am going to open with my one hand, which is hardly impossible. So what I am going to do, I am going to apply with two fingers to open it. So what I am doing, two equal and opposite forces, I repeat, two equal and opposite forces applied at two distance point but not in a straight line, that is called as couple. Now again, couple is again same thing like moment of force, but moment of force is applied only on one side because our axis is fixed, whereas here I show you again, we rotate it, we rotate the thing properly. So two forces acting, two equal and opposite forces but not in a same direction, that is called as couple. Is that clear? So simple example of couple in day to day life is your steering wheel of your car. You cannot go left and right by doing just by one hand. So we have to apply both the hands so that we can drive left or right easily. Second thing, regarding the pickle bottles, again you cannot open them with the one hand. The next important thing comes is regarding the olden taps, the tea taps like this. Tea taps are there, you have to apply the force at both the ends. So that tells you about couple. Is that clear? Then different examples are there. Then next comes regarding the static equilibrium and dynamic equilibrium. When the body is on the rest, now I talk about this. This body is on the rest. So this is called as static equilibrium. So body is not moving. So the weight of the body is acting downward. Normal reaction is acting upward. Next comes regarding the dynamic equilibrium. Dynamic equilibrium means body is in a motion. So when we talk about static and dynamic equilibrium, again we have to know certain examples. So dynamic equilibrium, important example is of raindrops which are falling from the above towards the ground. Is that clear? Now next topic based on this is regarding the center of gravity. Now each body is made up of small masses. Take them as number of masses m1, m2, m3, m4. Now since we are on the earth, the gravitational force act on that particular mass, so it becomes the weight. So the whole mass or the whole weight which gets saturated at the one point is called as its center of gravity. Now when we talk about different objects, center of gravity, only the L-shaped body means like the boomerang which is used to attack the enemy if you have seen in the African countries. So for that, the L-shaped body, the center of gravity is outside the body. Whereas all other things, now we have to learn about center of gravity, about circular cylinder, ring, cone, sphere, parallelogram, rectangle, squares. Is that clear? So we have to know its position. That is called as center of gravity, where all the mass or all the weight of the body is getting saturated. Now for that we have to know the numericals. So please pay attention. We are going to talk about the numericals in this part. Only two types of numerical is there. First one is moment of force. It tells you about force into perpendicular distance. Second type of numericals are regarding the uniform meter rule. Now uniform meter rule we talk about, it is from 0 to 100 centimeters. We assume that the whole weight of the body or this particular ruler is saturated at its 50 centimeter mark. 50 centimeter mark is the weight of the scale acting. Why? Because center of gravity is exactly half of that particular object. Now suppose I put some weight, here some weight, here some weight. So it is perfectly balanced. But sometimes if you put some weight here, now suppose instead of the body is balancing at 50 centimeter, I have a fulcrum here. Fulcrum means some knife edge where the body is getting balanced. Some weights are hanging here, some weights are hanging here. So when by solving the numerical, this is taken as x, this way, this way. So this will go anti-clockwise, whereas this will go clockwise. So you have to remember the conditions when the weight of the scale is at 50 centimeter, but some weights are put, so our fulcrum or the balancing point has shifted before CG. Then the weights on this side goes anti-clockwise, whereas weight on that goes clockwise. This is the one position. We'll see one more position for that, so that you will understand it very well. I'll draw with a different marker so that it will get differentiated properly. Now again 50 centimeter mark. My fulcrum is here. Some weights are lying here. Some weights are lying. I'll take this as W1, W2. Same way I have W1, W2. Now in this case, this weights will go anti-clockwise, whereas this weights will go clockwise. So the numericals are based on that. Usually the examples or numericals comes in section A. This year paper 2020, more things have come regarding moment of force and less numericals were here. So next year definitely it will come based on these things. Now when we talk about 1 meter rule, it lies at 50 centimeter. But if they give you half meter rule means total distance is 50 centimeter. So the center of gravity will lie at 25. So the important thing in this is what? We should understand how is the position. Don't try to change the units from GF to KGF, because according to the moment, the principle of moments is what? Anti-clockwise moments is equal to clockwise moments. So we have a further advanced thing. It is what? Sum of all anti-clockwise moments is equal to sum of all clockwise moments. So there it is equal to, in between the both sides we equate, so that no need to convert and get ourselves confused. So that is called as moment of force numericals based on scale. Now the last part in this lesson comes about, I hope you understood what we have learned so far. We will go to the last part of this lesson, which tells you about uniform circular motion. So any motion which is uniform circular, for example, when we talk about Earth, Earth is rotating around the sun. Same way, Earth satellite, which is moon, which rotates around the Earth. So that is called as uniform circular motion. Now uniform circular motion is also called as accelerated motion. Why again? I repeat what I have done it in the beginning. Since speed is constant, but direction changes, therefore it is accelerated motion. Now last part in this we have to know is about centripetal and centrifugal. Centripetal means which is center seeking forces are called as centripetal forces, and they are real forces. They are what? They are real forces. Whereas centrifugal force is the fictitious force, which means what? They do not exist, but they promote something that we'll learn in few seconds now. So centripetal force is what? The forces which are real and which are center seeking, whereas centrifugal forces are fictitious, which go away from the center. Now it is for momentary thing, it is not actual existing. For example, a stone is tied, and in the field you are there and you do this stone tied to a string and we do like this. At one particular moment we feel that the body is going away, but it exactly doesn't happen. Everything falls down to the center. Same way if you are in merry-go-round, suppose in Imagica you are in a swinger. At one particular moment you feel that you are going away, but if rope is cut, everything will fall down. So the centripetal force and centrifugal force are not based on Newton's third law of motion, action and reaction. Action and reactions are depend upon two bodies, whereas centripetal and centrifugal force is on the same body. Is that clear? They are equal and opposite. They have equal magnitude, but they are not equal and opposite like we talk about third law. So is that clear? So I'll just brief the things what we have learned so far. We learn about transitional and rotational motion. We learn about moment of force, its SI units and CGS units, its conversion. Then we learn about couple, its examples, anti-clockwise, clockwise. Then we talk about center of gravity of different objects, their positions exactly, state their positions or show their positions. We have to draw the diagram. I'll just give you one more example. As we are coming to an end, if you see this right circular cylinder, so exactly this will be your CG. The center of gravity is also called as CG. Next comes about the uniform circular motion, and after that comes the centripetal and centrifugal force. So hence we have completed the first chapter of the force, but we have done only the theory. Where numericals are left out to be solved, which were based on the uniform meter scale. Thank you.